Hey, thank you, brother. See you tomorrow. Hasta mañana.
Yes, nice to meet you.
Okay, the IT. Okay. Donc mon papa est okay de pour la France. C'est bien connu.
Mais comment vous c'est des quelques consulados, quelques qui dans quelques personnes aux États en Haïti. En Haïti.
Donc, ok, donc ça c'est la première fois que qu'on fait ça, qu'on fait on est avec cette organisation. Alors, donc on savait pas qu'il y a des Haïtiens ici en Mexique.
Ok, c'est pour la première fois.
Voilà, c'est ça.
Okay.
Mais mon papa, il veut aider les personnes en Haïti.
Okay. Est-ce que tu as beaucoup d'expérience et beaucoup d'expérience c'est qu'il est en Haïti?
Moi, non. Yeah. J'ai jamais visité Haïti.
Jamais.
Mais mon frère, il est là aussi, pas avec nous, mais il est dans un autre.
Okay. Voilà. Mon frère, il est entré en Haïti à plusieurs.
Voilà, donc il a visité Haïti et il veut aider les personnes là-bas d'apprendre anglais. Donc.
Okay. Je ne sais pas si. Il n'y a pas aucun projet pour.
Non, pas le point.
Pas encore.
Oui, pas encore. On espère un jour. Voilà. Ça sera vraiment top. Okay.
Mais je pense. Ça, c'est une idée personnelle. Je pense.
Oh oui, ça c'est ça. Oui, j'aimerais un jour. Hi, my name is Kenny Augustin, and today I had an amazing experience. I had the opportunity to be here at the shelter and help serve food, breakfast for the refugees. And it was surprising to me to hear that they feed almost more than 1,000 people a day. And it's so sad that there are so many refugees here, but I was so grateful for the time that I had to spend with them and to help them and to serve with the great people here too who work here. It's amazing. I felt great doing it, and I met a lot of really nice people as well. So this is an experience that I will remember for the rest of my life.
Great. And tell me a little more about your experience in speaking French with some of these people.
Oh yeah, so it turns out a lot of these refugees are from Haiti, and that's where my parents are from. And so I'm able to speak with people from my parents' country, and that's amazing. And a lot of them, they come here and they don't know Spanish, and they feel out of place because they can't communicate with the people here in Mexico. And so it's so wonderful that I'm able to communicate with them and speak with them. And yeah, it's great. It helps me to practice my French, which is amazing. And I just feel so great that I can just even bring a smile to someone. So.
You did. In addition to the obvious language difficulties, though, and was there anything else that you learned from talking to them about the challenges that they face here in Tijuana?
A lot of them, you know, I would just ask them simple questions. I'd ask them if they even like being here, and a lot of them said they didn't, just because they don't have family here. They're all alone, and like I said, it's a place that's unknown to them. So that was just sad to hear that, but then. I do know that the people here in Mexico are trying to help and trying to make a difference. And they try to talk to them even though they can't really communicate, and that's something that's amazing. So even though it's hard for both the refugees and the people here, they still try to make it work.
Okay. So are you ready to come again tomorrow to serve?
Yes.
Great. And how many hours today did you serve here? About?
We were here around 7. I would say around 7. And
it took how long to serve the meals?
It took a while.
Past 11, tired, right? Yeah. Almost 12. Yeah.
Yeah. As you can tell, I'm a little tired. So yeah, it was a long time. We were on our feet the whole time, just setting up tables.
And what exactly did you do to serve?
Me and Tara, we were the bread girls. So first we just put bread all over the table for the refugees. And then at one point, I just started setting up a table, so putting napkins and plates for them.
And cups.
And cups.
Great. Well, you did a great job today. You had a great experience. And I look forward to having you with us tomorrow.
Thank you.
Se ocupa de futebol, bateu.